Hello guys, I am using Blender 4.3 here. So if you have still not installed Blender in your computer, please do watch my video on installing it. Let's start with the general file type. So to install the Bonsai BIM addon, go to Edit and then click Preferences. There go to Get Extensions and search for Bonsai. Make sure you have internet connection. When Bonsai appears, click on the Install button. It will take some time for the installation. It's better if you have a basic knowledge on Blender navigation as well as modeling. And if you're a complete beginner, you can refer my tutorials on these basics. When it is installed, go for the Add-ons tab and make sure the Bonsai is checked. Now you can close the preferences and you can see that the interface has been changed. To create an IFC project, go for the project overview on the right side. In the IFC schema, select IFC 4.3. And in the template section, go for IFC 4.3 demo template and then click create project. For your better understanding, I have screencasted the mouse as well as keyboard buttons in the left bottom so that you can exactly follow me. In the right side project overview, we can see the project structure, my project, my site, my building and then my story. Now I am renaming my story to the ground floor. Now let's save the project, go to file, then click save IFC project. I am naming the project as plan.ifc and click save ifc. Let's start with drawing a wall. In the left side toolbar, we can see an icon called wall tool. Select that. You can go to the top view by clicking the backtick key and selecting top. To pan, you can use the shortcut shift and middle mouse. And to orbit, you can use the middle mouse key. You can select the wall type on top of the toolbar. Now I am selecting wall 200, which means the wall of thickness 200 mm. I am using shift and right mouse to move the 3D cursor. To create a wall, you can click the add button on top of the bar or you can just press shift plus A. To guide the line in Y axis, click Y and press 3 to enter 3 meters. Now click X and press 3 meters and again Y and click 3 meters. Now close the wall by clicking X and clicking 3 meters. You can see the last two walls are not being joined. Click any new keyboard to pop up the sidebar and click shift click both the walls together and select trim to join them, or you can use the shift T shortcut. Now it looks perfect. To add a door, you can click the door tool below the wall tool, and the door tool also have types. Now in the demo template, there is only one door type. To add the door, press shift A and you can see that it snaps to the wall. I am placing the door here by clicking the left mouse button. To see the door, you can just orbit the model by using the middle mouse and there you can see the door. In the top view, you can't see the door, so we need to create a plan drawing. For that, go to the right section and click Drawings and Documents. There, click the down arrow on the drawing section. Select Plan and instead of Origin, select Ground Floor and click the Add button. Now you can see that in the Plan section, a ground floor plan has been added. You can activate that view by clicking the camera. But the plan looks tiny. We need to reduce the width and height. Select the width and height together and click 5 and enter. To adjust the camera view, disable the snap, then click the camera, press G to grab and move the camera, place the plan centrally in the camera view. If you notice the door's orientation is not correct, to correct this, select the door and go for the tool section in the sidebar, then click flip. You can use shift F also. Press G to move the door, Y to lock in the Y axis. And correctly place it and click left mouse button. You can left click and expand the door tool to get the window tool. After selecting the window tool, you can shift A to add the windows to the walls. You can correct the orientation by clicking the window and then using G to move, and you can enable the snap to snap it to the edges or points. After pressing G, you can use click X or Y to lock in the respective axis. Now still we are in the model view. To view this in a 2D drawing, you can create a drawing. For that, you can click this icon here to create this drawing. Now you can see that one drawing is created. You can click the I button to view this created drawing. And this is an SVG file. It directly opens in a browser. In the drawing section, you can adjust the scale of the drawing and recreate the drawing again. Now if you look at this, the details has been increased as we changed the scale. Now let's try to change the properties of the wall. Select the wall, go to the object information tab, and there you can see the wall type. Click the select type. Now the wall's type has been selected. Go to the geometry and materials section. Here you can see the materials. There it is written IFC material set, and in the layer set name I am typing brick, and under that you can edit the thickness of the wall also. I am here using 40 centimeters. Now you can see that the wall thickness has been changed. Save the settings. Now go to the drawing sections again to recreate the drawing. Now if you see the drawing, the hatch has been updated as we put the material as brick. Also the thickness has been also updated. Now let's put some dimensions. For that, click this annotation tool and select dimension from the top bar. Bring the 3D cursor in the wall and click Shift A to create a dimension. You can select the vertex select mode here and then click the vertex and press G and Y to move it to the opposite wall. Now press Tab key and get out of the IFC item mode to IFC object mode. Click Tab to enter item mode and click Tab again to edit the item. You can use Shift D to duplicate, and you can click the key R and rotate it by clicking 90 degrees. You can use the snap to grab the vertex and snap it to the endpoints. You can disable the snap to easily move it as per your freedom. Now click Tab again to get out of the item mode to object mode. To add an annotation text, you can click the text from the menu and Shift E to add the text. You can edit text here. I am labeling it as room 3 meter by 3 meter, and you can click OK. Now it's looking good. Let's create the drawing by activating it first and creating it. You can see that the text has been added. To change the size, you can change the size from regular to large and recreating it. Now the size has been changed. For the CAD fans, you can create a DXF drawing of the same by clicking in this icon to create a SVG to DXF. You can see the DXF file has been created. To see that, go to the folder location. In the drawing folder created, you can see the DXF, and I am using Librecad to open the DXF file. It is also an open source software. The other drawing we created was an SVG file. To convert it to PDF, I am using a software called Inkscape. For both Librecad and Inkscape, I have done the tutorials on how to install it. We can use the file export to export it to the PDF file. Here I can select the type as PDF and click save. The file has been saved as a PDF file. More than that, in Inkscape we can edit the drawing we already created. We can edit the text, edit the hatches, edit anything we intend. Now I am changing the position of the text, you can see. Now let's do some edit on the hatch. I am selecting the hatch. Let's go to the color properties. It's a hatch. We can select multiple hatch patterns from here. Now I am demonstrating some of that hatch patterns. Actually we can manipulate the hatch in Blender itself, but it's quite advanced. In Inkscape is also an SVG supported software. So we can easily tweak these hatch patterns here. You can change the colors, the transparency, the opacity, anything to you intend to change. After the edits, you can again go to the export tab and you can easily export it as a PDF. You can easily open the vector quality PDF file here, and this is generated from a 3D model using the OpenBIM technology. In further tutorials, I'll be dealing with the all aspects of BIM, so stay tuned.